describe Richard Bell?
He has a passion for art, but he has a love for protest.
I'm an activist masquerading as an artist.
He really has that political edge to his art.
He's going to prod you and he's going to put a hot needle and it's going to hit the nerve.
There's two types of Richard Bells.
There's Richie and there's a Richard.
He's actually very sensitive, and that fierce intelligence comes from what he's endured.
Had my home bulldozed when I was 14, and that pretty much shaped me. I was politicised here in Redfern.
It was such an ingenious protest. These four young men turning up to the lawns of Parliament House with nothing but placards and a beach umbrella.
And it made the greatest statement we ever made.
Aboriginal art has become a commodity. It's not controlled by Aboriginal people. Why can't an art movement arise and be separate from, but equal to, Western art?
We've been able to create a space for disenfranchised voices.
Perhaps one of the most important Australian artworks of all time.
He has captivated the world, basically, but not Australians.
And the young kids coming through, to know that they've got heroes embedded in the past of this country, and that's where they can draw their strength from.
He paints what we think. He paints for us.